The chemical insecticides developed during and after World War II initially were effective and cheap. Farmers came to rely on the new chemical methods of pest control, which rapidly replaced traditional forms of chemical, cultural, and biological control. The 1950s and 1960s were a time of an insecticide boom, but use continued to rise, and insecticide application is still the single main pest control tactic employed today. I'm Dr. DeBusk, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the effect of insecticides, mechanisms of resistance, and tactics for resistance management. Although pest populations are suppressed by insecticide use, undesirable effects include the following. 1. Selection for insects that are genetically resistant to the chemicals. 2. Destruction of non-target organisms, including pollinators, the natural enemies of pests, and soil arthropods. 3. Pest resurgence as a consequence of 1 and 2, a dramatic increase in numbers of the targeted pests can occur. For example, severe outbreaks of cottony cushion scale as a result of DDT use in California in the 1940s. If the natural enemies recover much more slowly than the pest population, the pests can be greater than before the insecticide treatment. 4. Secondary pest outbreak, a combination of suppression of the original pests and effects 1 and 2, can lead to insect species previously not considered pests being released from control and becoming major pests. 5. Adverse environmental effects resulting in contamination of soils, water systems, and the produce itself with chemicals that accumulate biologically, especially in vertebrates, as a result of biomagnification through food chains. 6. Dangers to human health either directly from the handling and consumption of insecticides or indirectly via exposure to environmental sources. Despite increased insecticide use, damage by insect pests has increased. For example, insecticide use in the United States increased tenfold from about 1950 to 1985, while the proportion of crops lost to insects roughly doubled from 7% to 13% during the same period. These figures do not mean that insecticides don't control insects, because non-resistant insects clearly are killed by chemicals. Rather, many factors account for this imbalance between pest problems and control measures. Human trade has spread pests to outside their range of natural enemies. Selection for high-yield crops often inadvertently resulted in more pest susceptibility. Extensive monocultures are common, with a reduction in sanitation and other cultural practices like crop rotation. Finally, aggressive commercial marketing of chemical insecticides has led to their inappropriate use, especially in developing countries. Insecticide resistance is the result of selection of individuals that are predisposed genetically to survive exposure to an insecticide. Tolerance, the ability of an individual to survive an insecticide, implies nothing about the basis of survival. Field-evolved resistance is genetically based decrease in susceptibility of a population to an insecticide caused by exposure to that insecticide in the field. Over the past few decades, more than 700 species of arthropod pests have developed resistance to one or more insecticides, as well as resistance to toxins that have been genetically engineered into major crop plants. The silverleaf whitefly, the Colorado potato beetle, and the diamondback moth are resistant to virtually all chemicals available for control. Chemically based pest control of these and many other pests may soon become virtually impossible because many show cross or multiple resistance. Cross-resistance is where the resistance mechanism for one insecticide gives tolerance for another with the site mode of action. Multiple resistance is resistance of two or more pesticides with different sites of action. This figure shows resistance of plants to herbicides, but is the same in insect pests. Mechanisms of insecticide resistance include increased behavioral avoidance, as some insecticides such as neem and pyrethroids can repel insects, and physiological changes such as sequestration, trapping toxic chemicals in specialized tissues, reduced cuticular penetration, or accelerated excretion. Other mechanisms include metabolic detoxification by specialized enzymes and increased tolerance as a result of decreased sensitivity at the insecticide target site. Plant-feeding insects, especially those that feed on multiple plants, frequently develop resistance faster than their natural enemies. They may be pre-adapted to evolve insecticide resistance because they have general detoxifying mechanisms for compounds found in their host plants. Insects that chew plants or consume non-vascular cell contents appear to have evolved pesticide resistance more than phloem and xylem feeding species. Management of insecticide resistance requires a plan for controlled chemical use with the primary goals of avoiding or slowing down the development of resistant pest populations, causing resistant populations to revert to more susceptible levels, and/or causing resistance in natural enemies. The tactics for resistance management includes maintaining reservoirs of susceptible pest insects, either in refuges or immigration from untreated areas, to promote dilution of resistant genes, as you see depicted in this diagram. Varying the dose or frequency of insecticide applications, using less persistent chemicals, and/or applying insecticides as a rotation or sequence of different chemicals or as a mixture. The optimal strategy for reducing resistance is to use insecticides only when natural enemies can't control the pests. Resistance monitoring should be an integral part of management, so you can anticipate problems and assess the effectiveness of management tactics. In conclusion, recognition of the problems discussed, cost of insecticides, and a strong consumer reaction to environmentally damaging agronomic processes and chemical contamination of produce have led to current development of alternative pest control methods. Chemical controls are increasingly being integrated with and sometimes replaced by other methods.